Physical therapy is all about movement science, and movement is very, very difficult to show on paper, static, two-dimensional things. We really do rely very heavily on demonstration in three-dimensional and movement. You have to show movement with movement. It's hard to describe it or show it without having a moving image like that, so it's critical.
We're not, we don't have a belt stabilizing bridge's pelvis, which we probably want to do, or we could get our assistant to come and provide the counter force on the pelvis. But you can see how I can just use my weight, just use my legs to drive that, and it's very comfortable for me, and it's pretty comfortable for the patient too.
This technology came out of the golf swing video technology that was put into place to help golfers improve their swing. So what happens is that, as you've seen in the lab, the camera videotapes the faculty member performing a hands-on technique. The student can then review that videotape. They can, in addition, they can view the videotape themselves performing that technique, and then they can split the screen so they can look at their technique and compare it and contrast it to that of the faculty technique. And we are working on getting up and running the technology that will allow us to have the students superimpose their video on the faculty video so they can see exactly where their hand placement is missing. So in addition to teaching students, we hope that this will help us with in terms of research and showing that this technology makes a difference in terms of educating students.
And he looks about the same, so that might be just normal for him. He might be a little tight depending on the rest of his symptoms and signs. We kind of go through there and do some more special tests.
Good. All right, thanks very much. Come on back.
Primarily what it means is that students can learn hands-on techniques through the use of the video and also watch patient interviews being conducted in the clinic through the live video streaming that comes into the classroom from the clinic. So it puts us way ahead in terms of teaching skills.
It's fantastic because now we have a dynamic example that everybody in the classroom can see instead of everybody trying to crowd around one table and see a procedure being demonstrated. Now we can each look at the screens and everybody has a great view of the procedure and how it's being accomplished, and it's really important to see hand placement and see, patient positioning.
They'll be able to pull up that video in our lab or at home or in the library. Any computer that has internet access and has either QuickTime or I think it's RealPlayer, we'll be able to view those videos.